might have glipped out there a little bit. Have a good stream. Hope you feel 100% soon. Thanks. Appreciate it, bro. Get some sleep. Let's see. We need to strengthen the souls of the Direwood. Yeah, that's, if I remember correctly, that's what we did.
Tell me, do you remember when we last met?
Yeah, the Hall of Stars on Twin Elms.
You came to that tower seeking our aid. You prayed for help in reaching Theos, beyond the Court of Penitence, but would not pledge yourself to me. Still, a pledge unmade stands fairer in this court than a pledge broken.
She places a card in the middle of the arrangement. A bell tower with a rainbow. Her fingertips slowly drag away from the card, faintly creaking as they retreat across the table.
You had need of the gods once before. Now it seems we have need of them.
Oh?
The being that occupied Odmure's statue beneath your castle was the dead god, Aethys. Of this we are certain. What we do not know is what his intentions are.
Pretty sure I killed that dragon that was, like, made out of that crystal, too.
Though Aethys stole a large fragment of your soul, you were strong enough to survive the onslaught and enter the in-between. You and he are still connected. He has chosen a body made of living Audra, perfused with the power of thousands of souls, including yours. It should be little difficulty for an experienced watcher to find him.
Am I dead?
No. But neither is your body truly alive. Your lungs draw breath, your heart pumps blood, but your flesh is as soulless as a hollow bone. That is, until I return.
She delicately places a card upright on the table. The art depicts souls flowing out of a mirror of Audra.
I'd like to find out as much as you would. He destroyed my castle and killed who knows how many people around it.
I know. It's my business to know. 322 at your sword lines. Their souls remain in Aethys still. You have the power to save them. Serve me and I will return you to your body. Or don't, and return to the queen.
I don't know. That's the question, isn't it? Well, I think the only way we're going to get anything done is if we at least go along with this for now.
Good. Before you return to Aeor as my herald, you must remember who you were.
For a moment, the sockets of her eyes darken, leaving the pits of a death's head gazing out at you.
When you can picture your own face, the beyond will lead you back to your own kind, to the world of mortals.
Let's start from scratch. We could be in Amala. Oh man. What in the... Yeah, Gustavus is a human. Well, Mallow are pretty cool, though. I will give it that. I'm a little confused. Like, is she returning me to my body, or am I, like, reincarnating as someone else? Is this kind of like a Theo situation? Meadow folk. Eh, why not? We'll try and make, but gain access to higher level powers more slowly and come out. I think we'll go with a single class for now. So, we could go for another barbarian, but I kind of wanted to do more of a piratey run with this. A paladin would also not be too bad. I kind of liked the paladins from before. But I kind of have my heart set on the whole pirate thing. Hold on, let's see. I'm going to look something up real quick to see. Let's see here. Cypher could be pretty good. I do remember. Oh yeah, Cypher's the same thing that the mother one, the grieving mother. She was a Cypher, and I really liked how like they deal damage to get spells to throw back. That'd be pretty cool. For dual pistols. Take a look here real quick. Let's see. See, there's also Chanter. Let's take a look at the ability trees real quick. I know this is a little bit in-depth, but I am kind of curious what I can do here. Okay, yeah. What passive abilities we get? Additional weapon set. Yeah, quickest of his tribe. I probably will end up going with Cypher. I do really like them. Chanters are pretty good too, though. Take a look here. this is a tough choice. Decisions. I wonder. Decisions. It's always rough. Okay, what is the multi-class option? Oh, okay. Doesn't do much else with that. So, is there like any subclass? Ah, okay, there are subclasses. Okay. This is what I need to know. Okay. Okay. Alright, so that's interesting. What do we have for ciphers? Soul Blade. That's a melee strike. Not that interested. Beguiler. That's okay. Any good chanter stuff? Scald. That sounds pretty cool. Troubadour. Beckoner. Okay. Let's see, a Hellwalker. That's pretty cool though. Interesting. What else we got? Let's see here. Poor deflection, take longer to recover. Choices, choices. All drugs last longer. I do kind of want to do a cipher. I'm just not sure how exactly I do that properly. Because I kind of wanted to do more of a traditional pirate, swashbuckling, kind of dual-wielding pistols thing, which sounds more roguelike, to be completely honest. But at the same time, yeah, I feel like Cypher does work pretty well with this. Let's see here. Screw it. It might not turn out perfectly, but it's better than sitting here waiting. So let's pick a, we'll go with Cypher, and we'll go with guns. Now we just gotta figure out if we wanna go with the subclass or not. And also take a little gander at our Cypher ability trees. Okay. Mental binding. Burst around them. Enemy standing in the area when the target takes shock damage. Okay. Recall agony. Psychic echo. Ecto psychic echo. Okay. Soul ignition. Okay, that's not terrible. Okay. It's not bad. Yeah, I'm not really feeling the rogue for this. Definitely looking at the cipher. Does Ranger have anything else that is really... Yeah, that's kind of a meh. Don't I want to be a priest for this one? Yeah, it's looking more and more like probably Cypher here. Wonder how much. Yeah, I'm thinking that, yeah, we're just gonna go Cypher. Let's just figure out which one of these is, That's interesting. Increasing power level and reducing power focus cost to zero. So basically I just power up. That sounds pretty cool. like they're cocky and overconfident. That's kind of like the pirate thing. I like it. Just gains the ascended effect. I wish I knew how long ascended lasted. That is the only downside to that. I wish I knew just how long that it lasted. Generate more focus. I like it. It's like a build-up thing. So I'm going to kind of go with that. Let's see. There's echoes. Bring echoes for now. Past life. This is strong and siphon inspirations. Okay. Okay. So strength and perception. Sounds good. What else we got here? Soul Shock. We'll go with the Valorous Echoes. We want this to be pretty high. Might can go up a little bit. Okay. It's fine. Because we want high action speed, and we also want good accuracy. Hey there, Chief. You gonna be a pirate king? That's the plan. That's the plan. That is the plan. We're gonna try for a cipher pirate king. We're gonna see how that goes. Decisions. Pure cipher? Just tuned in? That's the idea, yeah. Oh, well, no, sorry, not a pure cipher. Ascendant cipher. So we're going to try that build up. I'm thinking we're going to try and use dual pistols to kind of complete the pirate motif, but if blunderbusses end up working better, then we'll use blunderbusses. Definitely want to crank that accuracy a little bit. Probably want some resolve, though. This is probably okay. Between pistol and blunderbuss, I do not know what the differences are in Path of Exile 2. This is my first time playing through Deadfire. So I guess we'll find out. The only thing I have read is that they do have like pellets, so like, you know, it has a distribution. So if you hit multiple targets, I think you get more damage or more focus back. So, hoping that works. Let's see. Powerful naval kingdoms. That's tempting. Let's be from the Deadfire Archipelago itself. Let's do it. What was your job? It's a raider. Wrong Side of the Law. Yeah, that sounds about right for pirate. What else we got? We got Explorer. You find the siren call, the horizon irresistible. Also decent. Drifter. We're more comfortable on the road traveling the world. Let's see. As a cipher pirate, people kind of are a little distrustful of ciphers in this world, so it might make more sense if I was like a drifter. But I like the raider idea. But we're not like a merciless pirate, are we? I feel like we're somewhat charming pirate, but we do, do we want to go full Blackbeard the Pirate? We'll go full blade in battle. We love ourselves a good fight. We're a pirate king, not a pirate negotiator. Alright. Let's see what we got here. Let's go for pistols, of course. And blunderbuss. A little bit all in, but that's the pirate life. Rapid shot, yeah. Yeah, that should work pretty good. Alright, we need something fitting here. What do we got? We're not a Viking pirate. There's not a ton of good portraits here, sadly. That one's pretty close, I'm not gonna lie. That one's pretty close. Let's see. Well, we can go with the same portrait we went with in Path of Exile 1, I guess. Wish there was one with like a good pirate hat that you could see. Oh well. We'll be consistent with the one we had from before, so alright. I should want to do this. On that. Nah. We'll have black with gold, or yeah, we could do like black with gold or black with red. We'll go with the red. We should have a little bit of a tan on us here. We are pirate king. We're not Gollum. Let's see here. Yeah, that'll work. Let's see. That'll work. Yeah, like blonde with a lot of kind of like dirt and some blacked out edges. That looks pretty good. Alright, head. Alright, what do we got? Oh, that's not bad. That's not bad. I wish there was a way to get it without him, like... you know what? If we could have an eye patch... If I could have an eye patch, I would totally go for this. Is there an eye patch anywhere? I don't think there's an eye patch. Dang. We can't have some pretty boy haircut. We're a seasoned man of the sea here. Aerodynamic hairstyle. Really? Alright, we're gonna go with this then. If we actually get an eye patch, that'll be perfect. We just need a good pirate hairstyle. Yeah, I imported my save as well. Maybe I'll get lucky in my inventory, I'll get one. If so, that would be absolutely perfect. You know what? This isn't the, like, quintessential pirate hairstyle here, but, like, this is closer to what I would expect. Like, this, like, slight ponytail. I feel like that works pretty well. Not perfect, but not bad. Like, it's either that or we go for some weird mohawk look, which I don't feel fits perfectly well with the theme. So we'll do this. Facial hair. Now, you gotta have a good pirate beard. This is essential. You cannot be a pirate without an amazing beard. Oh, no. There we go. That's not bad. That's pretty scruffy. Yeah, I like this one. Scruffy, yet also it's got some braids in it. Looks good. It's not a beard. It's a statement. Exactly. You get it. Alright, now we gotta get a good pirate voice. Not bad. Wish the music was a little quieter. But, oh well. Cocky it is. That's the one we want. All right, pose. Oh, that's a good one right there. All right, perfect. All right. Not terrible. I know, right? Like that would be rude. Like, I felt I was being nice. Like, I let that dude sleep underground beneath my house, and then he just pops out, steps on my house, kills my friends, and takes half my soul. It makes for a good revenge plot, though. True. True. Kicking the squatter out of your house. Man. If you want to give someone a good reason to come after you, like, yeah, popping out the ground and destroying everything they care about is... that's right up there.
I chime. Do not fear him. He will not harm you unless you choose to cross me. I trust it will not come to me.
Her gauntleted hand gestures to the dwarf, hovering nearby. The dwarf nods, contorts his face with his odd smile, and gestures to a new door.
Get that salt back with interest. I like that. I like that one. Ah, nice. We're walking planks. This is thematic already. Let's go. Who do we have here? Goosebumps rise. Oh, it's Eder. He's gonna be weirded out that I came back as not a barbarian. He's gonna be real weirded out by that. I come back as a pirate. Look, death gave me some perspective, alright? I'm done with the barbarian life. It's all about that loot. Alive.
I hate to cast a pall over your recovery, but I'm afraid I have some bad news for you.
The voice echoes from inside the bust. The remains of the steward of Cadmilla.
Cadmilla has been destroyed. Aethos possessed the statue of Maros Nua and rose from the ground, consuming the souls of all nearby. It is only by the exceptional strength of your soul that you survived. And even then, just barely. The further Aethos withdrew, the weaker you became. We chartered this ship and followed him to the dead air. I know not how, but it seems he has retained a piece of your soul. And proximity to it has brought you back.
I am well aware.
He pokes at your shoulder with one finger.
Misfortunes bring topside. We Martlands fired for Captain Sturz.
An older man with ale sour breath rubs his bloodshot eyes and stares at you.
Engrim, the smell of drink on your breath could wake the very dead. Now what's this about?
Pirates.
Pirates? Oh. I'm the only pirate around here. Arm yourself and get on deck. Should be some gear in there. Yeah, yeah. Well, here we go.
All right. Now make some use of this.
All right. Well, that's the icon. I see. Wait. Doesn't this slow me down? Does this go by the same thing it used to? Or does it not? Oh, it doesn't. It doesn't look like it does. Okay. What is that? Light armor? This is medium armor. Okay. Well, whatever for now. I'll look more into it later. Aw. I guess I don't have an eye patch. I'll have to find one. Note to self. Find an eye patch. Alright, time to enforce my rule. Let's go.
Ship now,
really?
Well, at least he asked.
I am a gentleman of fortune.
The captain shrugs in the sheeting rain before pinning with a slow, murderous grin.
Give her up, easy, and I'll see you get a swift death. It'll be bloody.
Fire on cannons, aim at the mouth. It would, hold on, which one would be good here? Pirates? That would be funny. Thought I was the only pirate. The storm's pretty loud. Did you say you're surrendering? How strange.
Then he's going to wear his breeches on his head and dance for us. Did I hear that right?
But the breeches are going to be stitched from your skin.
What is this? Dispositions. Oh, it shows the different things. Okay. I see. So it's the same thing as the first one. I like this interface. Like, this is nice. Oh, neat. Alright. I can get down with this. Alright. Let's see here. Rush reload. Okay. Dang. Okay. I'm not sure how many actions I get, but... powder burns, okay. So that will reduce my... Yeah, okay, okay. Yeah, it's a turn-based system. I wanted to try it out. I did the real-time with pause before. And I wanted to try this out because I always love turn-based systems. I'm not sure I can do anything else here. Yeah. Action use. I will have to get used to the action economy, though. That is the only thing. I don't think there's anything else for me to do except maybe move. Yeah, I'll move back here. And let... Oh, I can also... I can pause during turn-based? What the... Alright. You know what? I'll take it. Sure. Yeah, I guess I can't. So I have one attack. Okay. Gotcha. Alright. Never saw this? You know, I actually kind of like the look of it. Like, the UI is kind of interesting. Cut him down!
Defend the ship.
Shoot him right in his face! Mind if you follow up one or two? Yeah. That classic CRPG system. Okay, I already love these dual pistols. I'm sure if I was playing in real time with pause, it might look a little more epic. With me just like you're reloading and firing like a machine gun. But at the same time. Oh, crap. That's actually hitting my friends. Whoops. The water looks crazy. It does look pretty crazy, doesn't it? It's actually probably a good thing I'm doing turn-based, though, because if I were to try and position my guy and he, like, blunderbusses half my allies, that would be... Oh, that'd be so much micromanagement that I'd have to do to not get half my crew dead. You've defeated the pirates, but you're not out of trouble yet. The storm picks up, lashing your ship and driving you dangerously close to a rocky shore. The Defiant... nice call out to Star Trek right there. The Defiant's crew hurries to reduce the sail and batten down the hatches. They work quickly, but the ship is still listing. Just then, a crate tumbles towards you, gathering speed on a rain-slick deck. It misses you, but knocks Chitupic, one of your deckhands, off his feet. The Defiant heaves. Chitupic pitches over the side and grabs onto the rail, but his fingers are slipping. He cries out for help. Meanwhile, the runaway crate totters on the edge of the deck, ready to plunge overboard. It's salvage from Cadnua. First greedy choice. Oh, man. The loot or the crewman? We are a pirate king. But pirates do look after their own. We do look after our crew. That is the rule of being a pirate captain and a pirate king. So we'll rescue him. You grab him by the arm just as his grip fails. For a tense moment, he hangs suspended over the roiling sea. Then, with a mighty tug, you pull him back onto the deck. You hear a heavy splash, and the crate is gone. Figured. He nods in gratitude and hurries to his station. Meanwhile, the storm has nearly driven you ashore. A flash of lightning reveals a treacherous coastline and Eothus striding into the distance. The lookout barely has time to shout a warning before the Defiant runs aground. The impact hurls you from the deck and into the froth of waves, bodies, and splintering debris. You struggle towards the beach just ahead, even as the surf tugs you toward the open sea. You kick and paddle with all your might until at last you feel sand between your fingers. Pulling yourself ashore, you collapse. Edder runs his fingers through his hair and removes a strand of seaweed he finds lodged there. He examines it closely and then tosses it into the sand.
If you're worried about the ship, you can stop worrying. It's wrecked right over there.
He points out the Defiant, despite it being difficult to miss from your vantage point.
So far, it's just you and me, the chair lady over there.
He nods at something further up the beach.
It's a relief to see you awake, my lord. I worried you were in for another long sleep.
I hate boats. That's funny. Where are we?
Difficult to say for certain. The dead fire is spotted with islands, some quite small. The good news is that if the storm hasn't spun us round entirely, I'd say we're in charted waters. I believe the Valian Trading Company operates in the region. Hence that little visit from that wretched pirate captain.
Any help here, Barath? You know what? I'm gonna go with it. There's no reply save for the calling of gulls and the constant crash of water on the shore. Yeah, I figured as much. Can we patch up the ship?
Survivors, and somehow we gotta get the ship. I don't want to be paddling out of here on a salvage.
wondering how it came to pass that you were returned to us.
I like being, like I said, kind of like a pseudo-sassy Pyro King. This is kind of good. Turns out the gods are too dumb to figure out what Aethys is doing, so they sent me back here to figure it out.
Could be they're just not dumb enough to get in Aethys' way.
A perilous endeavor indeed. Castle or no castle, you are still my lord, and I will aid you to the best of my ability.
What is this, counters? Oh. Okay. I'm just curious what that was all about. Let's go. Swashbuckler. Wait, there's a swashbuckler thing for Fighter Rogue? Why didn't I know this? Why? I would have done this. This is ridiculous. Oh, well. Next time. Yeah, he can just be a pure fighter. That suits him best, I think. Who said that? Oh. I see. Well, we'll be up there in just a second. Up we go. Defiant is looking far worse for wear after its unexpected landfall. The hull has splintered in several places along its keel, while the tattered sails stand as evidence of your battle with the pirates. The deck is well out of reach from here. The ship groans like a beached whale each time the waves roll in, but it doesn't seem to be listing any further. I'm a pretty dexterous guy, right? I can scale the hull. True. You climb nimbly up the side of the ship and reach the top without so much as breaking a sweat. Edder is not far behind, pulling himself up over the railing beside you. Sorry about the cough, guys. Still getting over COVID here. So that will happen from time to time.
You're looking better, Casita. That, or I'm worse off than I thought.
Oh, I like that one. Good thing I'm muted.
It's my leg, but Dico, it hurts even worse than it looks.
Nice. Craft a splint from some debris. Patch you up the best I can, but you want to stay off that leg as much as possible.
I wasn't planning on going for a run, Casita.
What does that mean? Valerian turned for captain. Alright. She watches you work with obvious relief. Make her pay money for the help. You got a point there. Agrasima? Not yet. Be rich. True. Should be charging for these services. Set up. Let's see here. Let's move. Oh, wait. That's me. Okay, never mind. That was me that got hit. Penetration, the cost of initiative. Okay. Okay, the action system is interesting. Alright. Well. Oh, nice. I'll take that. Attack of opportunity, maybe? No, okay. We're good then. Our initiative is quite good, I will say.
Watcher, over here.
Where are you? Oh, you're the guy I saved. He greets you with a relieved nod and checks the pistol at his hip. What happened?
After we made landfall, I woke and Beato was close by, swearing fit to bring Andra's wrath upon us a second time. We began to search for supplies. I came over this way in hopes of gathering some of that blood moss over there. I thought it might be of use. I imagine the boars had the same idea.
Alright, I'll go looking for him.
I will make for the campfire. I must get this pistol clean if it's going to be of any use. Be careful in there, Captain.
It's a pre-order bonus thing. I'm sure I can find a pirate hat though in an eye patch somewhere. We'll just have to look around the stores. Besides, we can't be a proper pirate king without a pirate hat. That is a requirement. Oh, stealth. Okay. Let's do this. Okay, you can stop hiding out. What is this? This is for block. Okay, sure. Can I get to them? And not bad. Alright, we knocked them over.
Take this.
Hey, watch your step.
I do need to be careful with these things. Oh, it's because one is a blunderbuss. Oh, okay. I thought it might be, because it was, you know, having that splatter effect.
Keep it down.
Oop. Oh, ow. Engage. Moves away the character engagement of provoke. Yeah, knockdown can do that. Yeah. I don't think I have any abilities for that, but we can try and knock him over. Or Edder can just walk up and smash him into bone splinters. Let's see. We have other armors, right? Initiative. Okay, so this does, what does it mean by, okay, with lower initiative values, we'll act quicker. Gotcha. You know what? We want to go as quick as possible, and we also want to look like an actual pirate. And that stuff makes us look a lot more like a pirate.
Here we go.
Not bad. And turn. Good job. Dang, thought I might actually get him with that. Oh, I get to go again? Alright, I'll take it. Okay, I should probably stop shooting at her. Okay, yeah. It has not changed too much from the first game. At least not in its base mechanics. How does this go? I guess it's like a climb down. Here the waters here glow an eerie blue and the cave glistens in reflected light. You can just make out an opening in the cavern's wall to the northwest where the water flows onward. The tunnel seems to extend a short distance before turning sharply, but you cannot see where it leads. Swim through! Each taking a last gulp of air at the surface, your party swims into the tunnel, following the cavern wall as it bends. Partway through, Edder starts to lag behind. Panic sets in as the remaining distance becomes clear. Cassavis returns to help, pulling Edder forward to safety. Once you come up into what appears to be another small cavern, where sunlight streams in from an opening in the stone. Let's see. Ah, okay. Well, interesting. So, over here. Oh, this cough, just leave me alone. Oh, a chest with goods. Perfect. And weapons. Nice. We can put that instead of the blunderbuss, and we can stop friendly firing poor Edder. Alright. And then for Edder, do we have anything better for him? How's that shield doing? Medium shield. Is there any difference between these two? No. Just kind of shape. Okay. That's fine then, I guess. Saber, 18 to 26. 14 to 20. Love that animation. Him just sitting there smoking. Yeah, it's really nice to see Edder again, too. Like, especially, like, years later. He's kind of like, you know, a bit older, a bit wiser. I think we're good for now with this. Hello, ghost. Hold on, Animancy Tech?
Oh yeah, one of the crew got it off the alien bungholes. The ones locked with the fancy ships and jaunty caps. We swipe things from them all the time.
Looks like the rocks here did a number on your boat.
I think I remember something about a boat. Yeah, and some screaming. Look, maybe we should stick together. Feels right, you know? Well, with you being the only other thing around and all. I can give you a hand with,
No kidding. I've always wanted a ghost friend.
And I've always wanted to be a ghost. Look at us, all in a gourd. We like two peas. I just hope you know where you're going, because I ain't got half a clue.
Tries to give you a friendly pat on the shoulder, but the hand passes right through you. Hey, you never know. Ghosts may come in handy. Maybe she can lead us to some treasure. Swam through. Tell that ghost hands off. Hands off. She can't even hold any gold. It's perfect. This is a breakthrough in pirate labor relations, honestly. She doesn't need to eat anything. You don't have to pay her. What's she gonna do? What's she gonna use gold for? A watcher, not a feeler. More skeletons. I thought there was like a boar that ran in here, not a bunch of skeletons. Holy crap! I just got absolutely shot to pieces. Okay, maybe wearing some armor is a good thing. I'm gonna be joining that ghost here in a second, it looks like. That was some damage, let me tell you. Did you just beat the first game and jump right into this one? I beat the first game a couple weeks ago. I did a whole playthrough on it here on Twitch. I even uploaded it. It's all on the YouTube channel there too. I did a whole big playthrough of the first one. And I meant to jump right into doing this one. And then I got COVID. So, after I got COVID and I got really sick, I was like, alright, I'm gonna take a break until I'm feeling better. But yeah, basically. Yeah, after that, I was like, alright. Sounds like I made it. Yeah. Thankfully. This is the second time I've had it, so. You know. Oh, Lord, hold on, I checked the difficulty. Where's the... Can you not turn that off anymore? There was a... There was an option for turning off, injuries after you get back up, which I really liked, but... Alright, whatever. Fair enough. I shall live with the mistakes of getting shot. It's also cool they have a little animation for it. But yeah, made it through, and now I can get back to streaming a bit. Thankfully, the second time having it was not as bad as the first time, at least for me. The first time, when I first got COVID, like last year, no thank you. That was no fun. Oh boy, that's a large construct. Oh, let's move back. Ooh, he got a graze in. I don't know where. Okay, so I only get one avail. Okay, so I have one action there. Okay.
Take this.
We'll get there eventually. What does this do exactly? Maybe I'll turn this off. We do want to hit this guy. Okay, nothing else we can do. Oh, nice. Much better. Unfortunate. Maybe if we're a little bit closer, we'll get a little better accuracy. Does it take an action to cast? It does take a standard action. Nah, I'll just keep shooting him. We almost got him anyway. We're gonna have to up our accuracy here. That's gotta be it. Scroll of fan flames. Cool. Who do we want to put this ring on? I mean, as much as I would like the ring, probably would go better on Edder. Let's see. Yeah, we'll put it on Netter for now.
Pirates, Audra, take your scabrous souls for fish food.
Beodol, still alive and calling everybody scabrous, I see. Well, now we got a bosun.
Adair, when I see that corpse we've been carting around, it's looking a slight more sprightly.
Hey.
Good to see the two of you. Mind your step. I've got myself in a spot of trouble. I've been trying to find a way past without losing a leg or getting a face full of poison.
Just gonna throw some stones at him. The cacophony has ended. He peers out from between his fingers and gives you a grin.
Good thing none of them were of the exploding variety. Well, they got a kick out of that, I bet. It's just bats and stinking corpses in this cave. Find anyone else?
Got a camper on the beach.
See you on the beach, Captain.
Oh, now I'm captain and not a corpse. I've been promoted. Some other armor in here too, isn't there? Yeah, there sure was. What does this look like? Oh, here we go. That's what I'm talking about. We are a true man of class now. Alright, let's get back to the beach. Find some armor? Oh, you can say that. Look at that. Ah. Quite debonair, if I do say so. Now we just need to find that pirate hat. All right, back to the boat. He looks like he pays in cash. You're damn right he does. He doesn't just pay in cash, he pays in gold doubloons. Ooh, an actual sword. There we go. Quest, please. Is that all of them? Okay. Stranded. Wait, is this the ghost?
Hope the rest of those sodden bastards made it.
What is this guy's accent? I do declare, this beach is quite sandy. Alright then. I guess we keep looking around. Let's see if we can find anyone else. I say, their ship is wrecked. Yeah, that's where it leads out from there. Alright, let's just go further down the coast. Should be a speed up button, right? Yeah. There it is. Well, another one of my crewmen. Eld Ingram appears to be in sound condition. Though his wax jacket is soaked through, he appraises you with bleary-eyed amusement.
You woke just in time for the fun. Fighting off motherless raiders one moment, flung into the freezing depths of Andra's bosom the next.
So far I like all these characters. Even the gods can't break me, Ingram.
Some others might think that blasphemy. But when Margaret hears it, Captain, oh, she knows you're filled with a fire. It's me getting the ship back underway with the bears. Yonder Rodian land seems the best chance of that. You want to be kicking some of the corpses before you go, see if some fry out. Need a crew of 56. I'll see you at the campfire, Captain. Margaret's flame.
Yeah, there's a wedding. Oh, hey, I think I ranked up. Let's go. Let's go. So we got one passive skill point and one active skill point. Alright, so sleight of hand. Mechanics. Mechanics or sleight of hand, definitely, is what we want to go for. Explosives, though. Man, we're going to be wanting to throw some nice scatter grenades. Throw one of those deck clear shrapnel grenades, that'd be nice. Hmm. do mechanics for now. See, bluff, insight, streetwise. Yeah, let's get some streetwise in there. Choose one ability. I assume these are just all my... Oh, no, I actually have to choose. Do I? Alright. What do we got here? Don't need that. That could be okay later. Don't need that. I already have that. They lose initiative, accuracy, range. Not bad. What else we got? Damage spell, okay. Also not terrible. Confused. Not bad. We'll go with the charm spell. Make sure we can get in their heads a bit. I like this new like setup here. Like this is much, much more elegant than the first one. Like, the UI is really nice. Empower. What's this? You can now empower your abilities or yourself. Once per fight, you can use empower or an active ability to make it stronger. Internally, you can use some power on yourself to replenish a portion of your ability resources. Okay. So, I mean, I can use that to gain focus, because if so, that would make this build even stronger. To empower an ability, click on the empower, and then your action bar, and then select the ability to restore resources. Okay. Once per fight, and a limited number of times between rests. Okay. Certain drinks. Nice. Okay, that's a cool thing. I am down for that. Your characters earn enough XP to advance a level. Yep, I do know how that works. Alright. Alright, Edder. What are we going to do with you? Athletics. Definitely. And then intimidate. Yeah, I like that. Edder's my, you know, he's my first mate, so he's got the he's gonna intimidate our foes. Discipline barrage. Sure. Make sure we save. Alright, take a look at our journal. Spooky Island. Alright, let's do it. Forgotten Sanctum has been installed. You will automatically begin the first quest of this adventure when you receive a visitor upon the high seas after having progressed far enough. Okay. It's just telling me all the DLC. Okay. Yeah. Oh. Okay. I found some hardtack. You know the problem with that is? I actually know what hardtack is. It is, quite unappetizing, let me tell you. In the distance, you see a simple wagon. The angle at which it rests on the road, one side jutting above the other, suggests it's been damaged or disabled. Even from your vantage, you can make out Kith milling around. Let's take a little closer look. Ah, I failed. As you near the cart, you make out a group of Red Saren pilgrims in rough-spun linens and cotton. A single draft horse stamps at the ground impatiently as the two pilgrims argue over the front right wheel, which seems hopelessly stuck in the mud. One of the pilgrims notices you. Her step backward draws the attention of the others, and a man in well-worn gambeson steps forward. The weight of deep concern on his face. Did the dreams bring you here as well? The other pilgrims look to you with a mix of apprehension and hope. Dreams? We're farmers from Red Saris to work the colony fields here. We're believers all to the one in the light of Aethys. The other pilgrims nod fervently in agreement. A woman with a smiling baby lifts the infant's hand to wave. We've been having dreams, three stars sailing through the sky, piercing the black of a storm cloud. Back to the pre-ordering thing. Just bought the game last month, so maybe they slipped the old pre-order stuff into one of the DLCs or the Obsidian Edition. Ooh, maybe. I'll have to keep a look on it, because I know I have access to all the DLCs and stuff. Figured it must be him, Aethys, calling to us. So we came here to the place we saw in our dreams. The pilgrims look around, matching their sleeping memory to the present. We saw the giant pass with the three stars on its brow, but he sighs and gestures to the wagon in the mud. Sad to say, we cannot follow him. Alright, let's take a look. We do have some codes here. We're not going to steal from poor farmer folk. Like, we're not raiders. We're pirates. We raid on the high seas, and we're not this low. We're not going to try and steal from them like that. A brief inspection reveals that the wagon is undamaged, but the wheel is stuck fast in the mud. We have some wood, the old man says as he gestures the back of the wagon. If we can get the wheel up, we can slide that neath. Inside the wagon, you see several planks of wood. A small box of valuables sits to the side. One of the young Dawnstars looks at you, eyes wide. Reckon you can lift it? Yeah, I can lift it. That's all you, Edder. Edder squares themselves to the wagon's corner, squats deep, and rests the wagon wheel up from the mud with a grunt. A young Dawnstar stands in shock for a moment, reacting in time just to thrust the thick steel board beneath the wheel. It takes the better part of an hour to lay down the safe path for the wagon to roll free of the mud. The laboring Dawnstar glistens with sweat, but laughs happily as they sing songs of praise for Aethys. 2 hours pass. Smiling, their leader presses a small pouch of coins into your hands. We appreciate the help. Without you, who knows how long we would have been stranded here. They prepare their wagon and should take your leave. Alright, so we did get paid. Yeah, sure. The old man calls out as you go. Take care of yourself and your soul, traveler. Whether you came for Aethys or not, we know in our hearts that he has come for us. I like this. It's like a little more freeform exploration. I see. So what are they selling here? Inns? Oh. Found throughout the Deadfire. You can access a store, rent a room, recruit adventurers. Okay, yeah. The same as it was before, basically. Reputation. To bring up the character sheet with the reputations. Okay. Okay, I guess we can't get a room here, but that's fine. So we can look at our reputation. Oh, okay. Reputation UI. Alright. So what's this? Editor respects and enjoys cultural traditions. Yeah, pretty much, I understand him for the most part. Like, spent a lot of time, he was in the party the entire time. Yeah, this one should be cruel. Nice. Gotta get that clever disposition going. Like, clever and shady. Alright. Onward we go, I guess. What is this? The trail before you seems thoroughly disturbed by erratic tracks. The sparse plants to the immediate sides of the path are mangled. A struggle may have occurred here. Let's take a search. It takes you only a few moments to make sense of the chaos. No blood spatters suggest it was not a fight. You easily identify the claw prints of Zorups, and the tracks seem recent. A dry and ropey vine has been pulled taut across the path, inexplicably covered in dirt. So a trap, huh? Disarm it. As easy. It seems simple. You take care as you disarm it and collect its parts. Nice. Search for the Zorups. Hear a series of quiet chirps and growls ahead, and make out the movement of small forms through the undergrowth. Sneak closer and observe. You creep closer, parting the grass for better view. A handful of Zorups hiss and snap at one another, shaking their spears in their scaled fists. They stand over the apparent source of their argument, a small pile of loot likely stolen from travelers. Stoke their anger. You reach out. I can do this because I'm a cipher, yes! You reach out with your thoughts and brush the simple chaotic minds of the wilder. As if blowing on an ember, you encourage their anger. Their hisses grow more heated, and they begin to jab at one another. Finally, two leap at a third, who scrambles away into the overgrowth. The Zorups give chase. With them gone, you're able to collect what they left behind. A few coins, a tattered cloak, and an old stiletto. Hey, yeah, that's pretty good right there. Is this, like, a super dangerous place over here? So is there, like, a... They wouldn't just, like... Ah, okay, yeah, it's above your level. Okay. So that skull means, do not come here, you will die. Gotcha. Oh boy, another one of these Angwethan, like, alright, I do need to make a formation with this, though. Which is going to be custom formation, which is going to be me being, like, two steps behind Edder so that he takes the aggro. Alright, I go, and then Edder goes. Okay, good. Not bad. There we go. Ouch. That one hurt. Take Give him a good smack. Let's do this. Let's do a fast reload. Boom. Boom. Not too bad. Ow. Would appreciate not getting burned. There we go. We're gonna need to camp sometime soon, I feel. That's extra lock. Ooh, a pry bar. Very nice. Okay, scroll note. Take this coin out to the Huana village. See if you can round up anyone willing to do a week's digging for pay. Alright. Well, that's good. It means there's at least some villages around here. That's something to work with. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Don't do it. Don't do it! Ow! The hell? You can run that far and make two attacks? Rude. Temporarily frightening them. I'm gonna do that. Ow. Okay, well that's bad. See if you can knock this thing over, please. Whew, okay, that's good. Do I have any healing potions on me? I don't think I do. Oh boy, that's bad. Can I charm one of these things? Maybe? No. Alright, just shoot it. I'm not gonna get any closer to those things than I have to. Huh? What does this do again? Gain the wear inspiration. What does that do? What does the wear do? Grace is converted to hits. Okay. That's, yeah.
Leave it to me.
Okay. Alright, he is flanked. Thing is, Edder can actually take the damage. I cannot. Let's just, because that'll take time to cast. Those are standard actions. And a cast action? What does that mean? Oh, it also uses the action point. Yeah, okay. Gotcha. Oh, that's unfortunate. We can definitely kill one of these things here. This round. There we go. Alright. Let's, how close am I to? Oh, I'm like at 50. Nice. Should be ascended, right? Yeah, there we go. Good job, Edder. Alright. You go, Edder. That's unfortunate. Alright, what if I get just a little bit closer? Does that increase my accuracy? Oh, no. No, these rolls, please. I'm not meant to be a big game hunter. Yikes. Crafting. Well, can I craft something? Potion of a tomb self. That's pretty cool. Let's... Several men or women appear to be locked inside a cage of some kind. They're a little more than silhouettes behind the glass, pointing and gesturing.
You out there? Are the beasts gone?
Yeah, took care of them. The woman turns away to have a muffled exchange with the others. Then she pulls at something at the door and you hear a rattling clank. A young-ish man, with bright eyes and a twitching smile, claps his hands in joy as he steps out of the cage. The woman next to him, however, remains sober.
Governor Clark, you must have saved you to rescue us, no? But you do not look like one of his guards.
She raises to the balls of her feet and peers behind you as if searching for someone else. She looks to be only midway into her 30s, though the serious set of her mouth makes her seem older. I'm just trying to figure out what's going on. An older woman hawks an impression of gobble phlegm on the ground and kicks a clump of dirt.
You are here, and that is what matters.
What are you guys doing here? Corners of his mouth spasm. Cranky old woman next to him sighs and lays a comforting hand on his arm.
We were taking measurements of the luminous Adra when something strange began happening.
Fascinating. The pillar started to dim. The ground shook, and our instruments showed unusual variations.
That's when those of us with a grain of sense got into the cage.
The cage?
Something we made to protect ourselves from surges in the luminous Adra. Those have not been a problem, but I am grateful today for unnecessary precautions.
So what happened?
The Colossus. Some kind of construct made from luminous Adra. It passed through the arena toward the pillar. Moments later, the pillar went dark, and all of our colleagues outside the cage froze. Like they turned into ash.
Vanessa shoots him a furious look. He falls silent again. A confused and slightly injured expression crinkles her face.
Some of our people are still missing in the ruins, including Odorisi, our lead researcher. It is possible he managed to hide.
I should go see if I can find him.
Most of the ruins are that way, through the door next to the rust. If you are going below, you should take Aang first with you.
Hey, he looks just like...
Sharp-featured elf comes to the fore. As he meets your eyes, he gives you a knowing nod. It's Aloth, isn't it? Yep. He's earned a few new scars, but you recognize Aloth. I knew it. Hey, Tree. Thanks for the follow, man. But you recognize Aloth Corfisker. All the same. He taps a finger to his lips, and a sly smile works its way across them. Yes, I did. He was with me for like 75% of the game.
I do not expect the ruins will be any safer.
she looks to Olaf and he nods.
I would be happy to assist.
Yes, I use him a lot. The only times I really subbed him out a lot, I subbed him out a bit towards the end just so that I could have Durance a little more for some of the harder fights, just for heals. But I did have him around for quite a while. I really liked having him around. What else can you tell me about Aegfirth? I regret not using him more just for his story. Playing a wizard so I could... Yeah, I could see that. That's the same thing that I was sad about not getting to use... I don't even remember his name. There's a monk character that you meet in White March, I guess. And I really was kind of interested to see what he was all about. But I didn't need another martial character. Same with the like one rogue that you can pick up in the White March too. Yeah, I wanted to use them, but you know, like I was playing a barbarian. I already had Olaf, so like my front line was already pretty locked down, and I kind of just needed more backliners. Your Aegfirth is an administrator. I'll gladly accept his help. He gives you a quick smile.
Be careful.
I shall try. Thank you for your discretion. I'm certain you have many questions, but I fear they must wait until we're off this island.
Very well, we'll talk later. Ooh, I can make him a wizard, a battle mage, or a spellblade. We'll keep him a pure wizard. I could use a pure wizard. I feel like... I don't know if I'll play through Path of Exile 1 again, but I'm getting the feeling I'm probably going to play through 2 again. I really like a lot of these classes. They seem pretty cool. Pillar. Yeah. I don't know. I may have said something different with that. Yeah. Pillars of Eternity. Like, I might play through Pillars of Eternity 1 again. I probably won't play through Pillars of Eternity 1 again. But definitely with all these classes, like, I'm definitely going to play, like, Pillars of Eternity 2 again. Yeah, I said Path of Exile, didn't I? Yeah, of course. I think PoE, and the first thing it goes to is Path of Exile. It's a really good one. No more games with PoE initials. I only said to check the arena sublevel. People of Endor or something. I'm not sure if I'm gonna play Tyranny though. I thought about playing Tyranny, but I don't know. Copper bowl has been tarnished to a dull blue green. Grime and dust coat the surface in a thin film. Examine it closely. At the bottom of the bowl is a shallow circular depression. You recognize the offering bowl, an artifact found in Gwethan ruins. It would have been intended for use only by Ingwethans who held high rank, or that had made some great achievement. In such an arena such as this, a champion might fulfill that role. Haven't played it yet either, though? Yeah, that's the thing. I'm not sure if I'm going to play it or not. I might.
You're
I kind of like this. It's like the old crew getting back together. Like years later. It's very neat. Oh no. Not a puzzle. Don't do that to me, game. I'm terrible at puzzles. Hello there. Okay, so it's my turn. Okay, so yeah. Oh boy, that's. I should have shot that barrel. You got a spell to bail me out here? Oh, he sure does. He might be a little close, but. Oh no, it's gonna take time. Quickly becoming a new favorite. It's kind of same face right now. Yeah, you know, when I first decided I was gonna start like streaming, I really was like sitting down and being like, all right, what do I want to play? And like I chose, like, you know what, I always love CRPGs. I do DMing, you know, I DM a bit. I love this kind of stuff, and you know what, like, it's been amazing, like jumping into this. If I hadn't, like, jumped in this, this is really would have been disappointing. Because, like, this is, yeah, exactly the type of pirate game I wanted. Yeah, it's being exposed to this kind of game and, like, these kind of CRPGs, man, it's been a blast. Holy shit, that was. Speaking of a blast. Alright, note to self, that is far more damaging than I would have thought. But yeah, kind of like focusing on playing CRPGs has like led me to some really, really exceptional games. Like Pillars of Eternity being one of them, especially. Are there any other pirate CRPGs? You know, I don't think so. Like not like. I mean, I guess maybe Sid Meier's Pirates, maybe. But that's not like a CRPG. That's, you know, that's something else. Yeah, you know, I can't really think of any. I mean, maybe there are, but very few things get like. Dedicated like pirate stuff like this, which is really fun. The closest thing to this, which wasn't a CRPG, but the closest thing to this, like letting you have like a ship that you can like upgrade, stuff like that, that felt cool, was playing Warhammer 3 Total War, or no, it was Warhammer 2 Total War, when they put in pirate Vampire Coast pirates. That was pretty cool. Like, they have a whole, like, system just, like, building up this, like, massive warship that functions as, like, your base. It's really cool. I really enjoyed that. Especially if you're into, like, undead pirates. It was really cool. let's just throw that at you. Yeah, the graze is still something. I mean, I don't know of any, like, classical era pirate stuff coming out like this, but I do know they are, like, there are some things coming out that are, like ship-based, with a sci-fi related. I think it's, like, Rogue Trader is coming out. Same people that did Pathfinder, Wrath of the Righteous, and stuff like that. I feel like I maybe am not supposed to be down here yet, but. Ah, well. think we can handle this dungeon. I did run a, on a side note, I did run a, it wasn't like a pirate game, but I did run a big campaign once in 5e. I ran a campaign for, how many people were in that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I think I had like 5 or 6 players, and we did a, like a campaign, but the cool thing was it was like, it wasn't like Age of Sail, it was like early, like modern, or not like modern, but like Atomic Age, so like more like World War One into World War Two era, but there was a lot of like still private companies and ships, and of course there's deities and stuff and magic. So the party like basically got a they got a ship. It was a rebuilt ship from their previous campaign, like, and basically this God of the Forge rebuilt it for them and turned it in. It was originally like a destroyer, and he like rebuilt it and designed it into being this like basically like a dreadnought, like, and the campaign, that was what they built up like over the campaign, was this like big dreadnought that had all the space inside of it, magical implements and stuff. It was really, it was a fun campaign. Nothing better than having like a mix of industrial age and magic. It was a lot of fun. There we go. What am I looking for down here? I guess I'm just trying to figure out what he's after. Oh no. These guys were a big pain before. Yeah, not bad. Ooh. Alright. I should probably buff Edder. Ooh. Interrupts. I don't know how that works in turn-based. Yikes. Okay, do I have enough to cast this? Okay, I do. Alright, let's put that on Edder. Hopefully that'll keep him alive. Oh boy. Yeah, this, this area may be a little bit strong for me. But we can knock him down. Put him on his ass for a minute. Okay. Alright, this guy's almost down. Oh boy. Put him down on his butt. There you go. Man. Man, Edder is nice and strong. Well, let's just keep on going.
Yes.
The effects and everything in 2 here are much prettier. I mean, and of course it's a newer game, but much smoother, much prettier. Oh no. Put him on the ground. Alright, let's turn that off. Make sure we get our hits in. Yeah, this is quite nice. Looks like Edder can definitely tank this for a long time. There we go. Do we still need camping supplies? Drag food here. Okay, so you need food in order to... Okay, that's cool. I like that. Healing support. What else we got? Scroll of minor healing. Prayer body. Oh, this new... I like a lot of this new interface. -1 morale for eating hardtack. Yeah. Yeah, I can understand that. That's nice. You don't need camping supplies anymore. You just need, like, food. I imagine higher level foods and stuff like that will yield better results. Let's see, what we got for... What we got? We got a better weapon here? It's a fine dagger. That's a stiletto. Let's give him a sword. I would like to have him have a sword instead. Is this 4 deflection? Okay. It's fine. It's fine. Give him a tried and true sword. Alright, let's go this way. Customer. Alright. Alright, Edder, you're up. Oh, okay. Yeah, he's not hitting Edder at all. Good. Let's give him the good old Avada Kedavra there, Aleth. I do love whenever it's Edder's turn, he's just like, hey. Ooh, that was a nice hit. It feels like the wands have more impact. It is so nice to play an RPG where the wizard's primary weapon, which is usually a staff, not just their spells, because you know, your spells are usually limited, but it's nice to play a CRPG where their wands and staffs actually hit with some power. Frozen mid-stride, this grim figure is turned towards the colossal pillar of Audra that dominates the chamber. The ashen corpse, outstretched hands rest upon the crystal's dulled surface. Clutched tightly in the remnants of a fist is a bundle of papers, bound together by a leather cord. Several more pages are scattered on the ground at your feet. As you pull the papers free, the ashen fingers gripping them sloth away, disintegrating into a fine plume of dust. Standing here by the lone figure, you are struck with a feeling of dread. The air around you, the very motes of ash and dust, all of it stagnant and still. The feeling grows worse when you look up at the Audra and sense no energy flowing into its surface. It is as though it has been disconnected from the wheel.
Thank you.
Gotta get to my soul. Give me back my soul!
I still have need of it, but do not be afraid, Watcher. Dawn will come for us all in time.
Aethys yanks on the golden cord, pulling it from his back. The cord tears into filaments that blacken and dissolve to dust. Without pause, he turns to resume his stride toward the distant pillar of Audra, shining on the boundless horizon. You hear the souls within him cry out for just a moment, before your consciousness is snapped away from them. The in-between goes dark. For a second, you feel a mix of nausea and a sensation like spinning and falling. Then the moment ends. Your consciousness has returned to the Angwithan arena. The world is sideways, the Audra pillar upside down. You flinch at the feeling that you're standing on the ceiling. Disorientation overwhelms you, and you collapse to your knees next to the luminous Audra pillar. Previously dim and flickering, the pillar now glows with a strong and steady light. You touch the Audra again, but the chill and prickling sensations you felt before are gone, replaced with a comforting warmth, like the embers of a fire that has just lost its flame.
Dude just ran off with part of my soul. You feel a hand on your back.
We just got you back. Well, if you're not sure, now I'm worried. I've seen you commune with souls of the dead, but this looked altogether different. And what happened?
Edder punctuates the brief statement with a troubled sigh. It's basically told there's thousands of tortured souls inside Aethys.
Don't suppose he told you what he's up to, eh? Or at least where he's going.
Some more luminous Audra in his path, but he told me not to follow it. Something beautiful is coming. Well, crap. Well, let's see if we can find a settlement and maybe get our ship working again. I think this is the way out. Is this the way up? Maybe not. Oh, no. I remember this, because this is like a puzzle, and I was like, oh no, not the puzzle. Which means... this here's gotta be the way out, right? Yeah. There we go. Well, geez. As the souls move past you, some turn their heads in your direction, but most seem fixated below you. The Adra pillar beneath your feet. A few nod their heads in thanks or raise a hand in acknowledgement.
Doing it again. Good luck. You couldn't beat a holoborn in a personality contest.
Passes his hand back and forth across your eyes.
Want to share what you're seeing, or do I gotta guess?
Nothing really. I just saved countless souls by re-eliminating the Altar Pillar.
Sure you did. You saved a whole bunch of folks that you can't see.
You know, Edder, I liked you better when you believed in me, alright? A small group of souls has started to cluster around you. One of them is standing a bit closer than the others and gestures for your attention. Sure.
You have our thanks. We appreciate that you showed us the way to the Adra. But what if it goes dark before we reach the beyond? Thank you, Watcher.
Man, I hope I get to command some kind of soul army. Well, that sounds cool. Alright, what do we got here? Well, we could use some stealth. Gonna need to know how to bluff. It's your weapon style. Versus, okay. I'm a little confused. Is there no difference between these two? Oh, okay, so this is, no, that's draining whip and that's biting whip. Okay. Enhances the draining power of Cypher's whip. More focus, more quickly. Granting greater bonus damage. That sounds quite nice. Yeah, let's go with the more damage. At least for now. Nice. More initiative. It's always good. Alright, Edder. Time to rank you up. We'll do athletics and survival. Not a bad one. Equip shield, deflection bonus are increased, and grant bonus equal to the character's reflex. Not terrible. What is this here? Okay, interesting. That's pretty cool. Let's go with weapon and shield style, though, and determination for now. We just kind of want him to tank and just be as straightforwardly tanky and resilient as possible. Same as the first game. Alright, I can choose two spells. Oh, I wonder if we can add spells, probably like the first one, too. I don't think he's gonna need any of these, really. Let's focus on getting him some spells. Does he already have this? Are these the ones that it recommends? Or are these the ones that are already in his spell book? Assume that's already in your spell book. Yeah, because. Okay, yeah, I get it. Okay. Merciless Gaze. Nah, I think we want to just have him. We'll find a buffer, debuffer. I don't think wizards are very good for that anyway. I can also do some of that myself. I'd rather him just specialize in damage. Rolling Flame is okay, but not the best. Yeah, that should be fine there. Fetid Cress. It's very. It's a range of 5. That should work for now. I do have to remember to keep up with his spell book. Okay. Oscar Mar. Okay, I'm not really sure how I'm supposed to. How do I set up his spells? This seems different. Weird. I guess I'll have to look it up. (Clears throat) don't have necrotic lance in here anywhere. Oh wait, I do. Okay, I guess these are just like added on in addition to this grimoire. Okay, sure. Oh hey, loot. Let's go ahead and head out of here now. We gotta find a way to repair our boat. Sift through the wreckage. Hey, some supplies. Some lager? Hell yeah, dude. Was that a Nui shell? Okay. Alright, that's good enough for now. That's pretty darn good. Okay, well, I guess we keep looking up the road here to the north and see if we can find a village. Oh, okay, well, we found a port. Let's see if there's anything else. There's a burial site over here. Okay. Alright, let's go to this port. Spring 2828. The man at the center of attention appears to be fielding inquiries from both the gaggle of townsfolk gathered around the platform and a rather severe-looking Amawa woman standing beside him. Clario's gaze sweeps across the crowd and falls upon you, where it remains. A few more heads turn to see what has caught the governor's attention. My ship ran aground just south, and I need help. I just need some repairs and I'll be on my way. Sounds good. What's going on?
Centuries old, blessed by Nkati herself.
Magnificent.
What are you? Dang, if there weren't people watching me. Another servant. Strange events.
A few, well, quite a few people here in Port Martin claim to have seen a giant of some kind during the storm. I would call it a flight of fancy, but unless something has tainted every well in the region, I do not think it can be ignored. But then, a dead fire is a land full of such things. You must have heard the stories.
It wasn't a giant, that was Aethys. Is not the voiceless of understanding. What could I end up doing? I just got here.
Indeed. Which means I can spare you, whereas I cannot spare the guards. I have the guards on the lookout for pirate vessels looking to take advantage of whatever damage the storm caused. We've cannons enough to see them off, but I need every man ready to use them. There is a site of some considerable value elsewhere. A value to the trading company, you understand?
Beach to it.
It's the very reason any of us are here.
Beach to it, Clario. Your secret dig site isn't that much of a secret. Or dig site, actually. Editor points affably in approval. Saw the same destruction Aethys wrecked in Cadnua. Odorisi is dead along with most of your animancers.
I see. And the work?
Yeah, I found these. Don't really have a choice.
It is a strange obligation you are under. I understand a little of it. Lucky for you. If I were a more sensible man, I would take this favor and turn you over to you.
Yeah, this is using the Audra pillars as an energy source. If I can find more, I can find him. And that's where I'm going next.
I'll arrange it with Nikawa. Between the two of us, I'm certain we can gather the workers we need. Head down to the beach once you are ready to depart.
Thanks for the help.
It is only right. After all you have done for me. I won't keep you further. You have a long, very strange journey. Some advice. After you have had your audience with the Queen, seek out the Valiant Trading Company. They make their headquarters in Nekataka, and the company always appreciates good help.
Hey, I racked up again. That's what Martin Street was. Gotta know the ways of the world. Well, I guess I can't pick that one now. Oh, okay. Well, let's see what else we got here. A cast time of 3. I don't know what that means, but okay. It's not bad. Plus 5 resolve. Okay. Not bad. Ooh, immobilized, you say? I like me some immobilize. Oh, hey, I can pick another, I could take an arquebus. That could be cool. Yeah, we gotta be proficient in all kinds of firearms, including the arquebus. Let's see. If we find some heavy shields, we can have him use those. Alright, Aloth, you're up next. Arcana. Alchemy is also pretty useful, too. I'll put a point in that. We'll put a point in metaphysics. Hopefully we'll grab someone that can do religion. We'll find, like, a priest or something, maybe. Or a paladin would be nice, too. Chill fog, definitely. What should you use all magical implements with him? Let's go talk to that guy that like got beat up or whatever over here. Figure in bed is a young alien man. The first thing you notice is it seems to have been severely beaten. One eye is nearly swollen shut, where his skin is revealed a patchwork of livid bruises. Good lord, man, what happened to you? He groans and winces as he props himself up.
You know exactly how it feels. I beat up a lot of folks just the same way.
Come to laugh? My Diego, this would not have stood in Ozea.
In Ozea, there'd be a crowd here to taunt you. He barks a short laugh, then immediately winces.
Maybe you are right. So you are visiting. What do you want?
What happened to you?
Iswana. They are an unreasonable people. I was enjoying a night of cards when one of them attacked me, out of nowhere. I had not spoken a word to her. The mad devil. Look what she did to me. My ear.
Turns his head and you see there's a scabbed over notch where a chunk of flesh has been torn away from his left ear. Ouch! Does he get into a fight with Mike Tyson?
When the fighting is over, she takes my coin purse and strides away. Old as anything.
Yeah, you should always ditch the jewelry right before a fight.
I was deep into my cups. It was not a fair contest to begin with. Do as they please, and this is the result. I should be out there helping to search for our people to rebuild. Instead, listen, I am without a witness. She took my coin, my wages. How am I to pay the governor? How am I to feed my son? That woman should be in the stocks. Guards do nothing, but you've heard me out at least. Do me the kindness of retrieving that coin purse, and I will give you what I can spare.
I'm always up for a good fight.
They call her Mokea. I imagine she's back in her village, feeling proud of herself. Follow the road as it bends north, then west. You can't miss it. A pile of
of sticks and straw.
All right. There's an inn here too. I'll have to make sure we come back and check that out. Wait, what? Oh, I guess this is like... okay, so once I'm inside... Oh cool, that's awesome, that's population. There are 3,200. They import wheat. Silk, leather, cotton, textiles, anime equipment, marble. That's cool. I like that. It's a small detail, right? But like that's pretty cool. I like that. Hold on. Where do you want me to go? The Juana village northwest of Port Machi. Okay. Storm speaker. Seated upon the chair before the bonfire, Ikawaha? Looks considerably more comfortable here in her home village. She prods, good lord, absently at the coals with a long stick. Her lined face is pocked with fading scars, but there is no hostility in her calm appraisal. Doesn't look like the storm did much damage here.
To a storm speaker, the storm is a friend, gentled by a word. And Santa Huzi is blessed with several storm speakers. We were able to shield the village from much of the weather. Some of it is mere luck. Most of our canoes were here by the shore. We did lose one of our voyagers. It will take some work to replace it.
I guess you and the governor don't really get along. Thought you should know I found some Juana at the dig site. They were killed when Aethys arrived.
Governor Clario would call it superstition. I know you speak truth. Are there worse omens than to hear that the god of rebirth has brought death on your people? I thank you for delivering this news. I will tell their families and we will mourn them together. But you will journey on into the god's wake.
Okay, is causing trouble in town. She sighs deeply and folds her hands. I just need her to return what she stole.
Okeha is no thief. She has all she needs here. What need is she to steal? The Valians must be mistaken. Speak with her. You will see.
Alright. you have? What do you have? Cave coral. Alright, cave coral. The legendary ingredient. Sure. Buy some hagfish. And some fruit. Fight off scurvy. Ooh, some sausages. Hey, I don't need that. Well, I thought that she'd be in there, but she's not. Oh, there she is. She steps sideways, angling herself towards you, and meets your gaze with an immense stare.
I do not know you.
Very astutely observed.
You were looking for Kawa?
Rinko says you robbed him.
Rinko? The Valiant? You jest, Akira. I should have thrown him into the sea. He dares to call me a thief?
Last warning. I won't go down as easy as Rinko. Every trace of contemptuous amusement vanishes at once from her face.
When you come to our territory under the Elder's eye to threaten us, when you are dead...
What the fuck? The hell? I'm pretty sure I'm dead. I'm nowhere near high enough level to fucking do anything here except get my fucking ass kicked. Well, well, first it would be nice if you could go knock her on her ass. Oh boy. What the hell? She just turned into a werepig? Yeah, I may have just run myself over with that. It may have been a classical blunder right there. Okay. Well, that was something. I cannot do that. And just FYI, you have a tag for your first pillars instead of Deathfire? Oh, you're right! You're totally right. Thank you. I did not even see that. I need to fix that. That is... Oh, man. I will have to... Okay. Thank you for pointing that out. I did not see that. Oh, no. There it is. Done. There it is. Oh. I'm here under Governor Clario's authority. So you admit to beating him.
Yes, and so, I say he earned worse, yet I was merciful. Ikawa told me I should see the tower, speak with their people, learn patience. The traitor, Ilofani, she taught me to play Valiant Cards. A simple game, but none would play with me in the tower. Not until then. I thought him kind, until I proved the victor, and he grew angry. Until he stood in front of his kin and called me the islander and cheat. For that, yes, I beat him. Why does this concern you?
She told the guards you've been branded a thief.
I am no thief. Do you mean to insult me? I am Mataru. I am the guard in Sadahusi. I defend this village. If I see fit to punish a man, it is my duty.
If a Valelian broke Wana law, would you be satisfied with a fine levied by the governor?
That is not the same. This has long been our island.
Can't fight you as an equal, obviously. It opens her mouth to speak, then snaps it shut. She grimaces, averting her gaze to the sand. Shakes his head.
I did not consider this. He is Quaru. It is not in him to fight for the village. Perhaps I was impatient.
Give me the coin purse and we'll call it square.
Then here's what you came for, though it is an uneven trade. I will ask our chieftain to send a healer for that idiot thing. Perhaps that will help.
Cool. Problem solved, eh? Well, this time I did it without getting murdered by an entire village. Alright, well, that's a successful quest. Let's go back in. Oh, and they even added in shortcuts. Oh, bless these developers. It's so rare that you see developers, like, make things, like, learn and make things this much more convenient. Like, why is this not in every other CRPG? Oh, right there, that's just such a small thing that's so good. I don't have to, like, travel back to the city, to travel over here, to walk into his house, to wait for another loading screen. I can just, boom, travel right back.
Most days I'd fire up the ghetto before
you. I spoke to her. She claims she went fairly and you insulted her. We're not really a do-gooder in this playthrough. Yeah, she apologized. Here's your money.
Let her apologize to my face, the shark spawn. What good is an apology?
Yeah. Yeah, alright. I'm not getting involved in that. Some dude wants to have a tiff with them. That's none of my business.
Thank you.
All right. Let's take a little look here. See what we got.
Ado. Begging your pardon for the mess, sir. We are still recovering from the storm. We have supplies here for the paying customer. Have a look.
I'm guessing these are more. Whoop, that's not what I wanted. I just wanted to see what it does. What is a death rune? Being near to kill the enemy grants temporary damage reduction. That'd be really good on Editor, I'll give him that. Ring of Minor Deflection. Like, I do need some kind of armor for myself, though. Like, I get shot down real easy with this build right now. But that is quite tempting. These are not worth much, are they? That's unfortunate. Alright, well, I guess that'll have to do for now. Maybe I'll wear the leather armor instead. Base armor rating. It doesn't have the same like statistic outlines as the first one. Plus 2 deflection for 5 gold. Nah, I'm good. Like, this is okay. Death runes are okay, but not for this price. Like, 1,000 coppers, that's a bit much. I think I'll pass. Let's go see if there's anything interesting going on down at the tavern. No one has as many friends as the man with many cheeses. What the hell? Can I talk to this guy?
Sorry,
there he is. What? I have to hire some crew members for my ship. This is Adventures. Okay. A novice navigator. A novice helmsman. Yeah, sure. She's a surgeon. Seems pretty good. Oh, a cook. I mean, if you don't have a cook, what are you doing? Alright, we'll take on these ones. Malicious doesn't sound like a very good thing to have. So we're gonna leave it there. But that should be okay. That's like what, that's going to be like, maybe like 10 copper a day? I'm sure we can keep up with that. All right, that's good.
Race you to the coral. No contest. What? Just because you have webbed fingers and I can't swim? You are a strange man.
All right, I'm going to call it here. I will be back at this tomorrow, now that we're onto our new playthrough. But I'm going to go ahead and stop it here for now, and we will be back at it then. Thanks for everybody that showed up. Always nice to see return faces, new faces, everyone in between. And I will catch all of you tomorrow. Have a wonderful evening.